हेलो एवरीवन, आकाश है एंड आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू व्यू एक्स ट्यूटोरियल सीरीज. ओके सो गाइस, आवर प्रीवियस वीडियो वाज गेटिंग अ बिट लेंथी, सो दैट्स व्हाई आई डिसाइडेड टू कोट द ऑपरेशन फॉर दीज टू बटन इन दिस वीडियो. ओके सो ओके एंड यस, इफ टाइम रिमेन्स देन वी विल पॉजिटिवली कोट दिस कार्ड कंपोनेंट इन दिस वीडियो और एल्स इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो. ओके सो let's get started. Okay, so as usual, first we have to make two method basically. One is add to cart and second one is remove items. Okay, so okay, so now let's talk about like what we are going to do in this video. Okay so I will pause the video and I will write the algorithm. Okay, and then we will code as per that algorithm. Okay so let's think what we are going to do when we will be clicking on add to cart. When we will click on add to cart, okay, so let's get a better idea. Okay, so when we will click on add item, okay, first thing is our like this counter, cart item count, it should update. Okay, and secondly, our cart item array should also update so that we can render that list over here. Okay, so now let's see the algorithm. Okay. And what we will be doing is we will be performing mutation. Okay, mutation so that we can update the state of our store. Okay. Okay, so as I told you, what we are going to do first. Okay, so it has access to state as well as it will. Okay, so it has access to state and we will also pass payload. Okay, and so first thing that we are going to do is we will increment the cart item count. Okay, that too by one. Okay, now let's have a look at the algorithm. Okay, so what we are going to do, when we will be clicking on the item that we want to add to our cart, okay, so that we will receive here in payload. Okay, we will simply update this payload by adding a quantity property. Okay, and we will set that quantity property equals 1. Okay, initially the quantity will be equal to 1, obviously. Okay, then we will check if cart item's length is greater than 0. Okay, this cart item, okay, if its length is greater than 0, then we will check that this item, if it already exists in the cart item. Okay, if it already exists in this array, if it is yes, then we will find the index. Okay, then we will find the index of this payload in this array and we will simply update its quantity by 1. Because if it is already existing and if its quantity is like 2 or 3, then we do not need to make another entry. We will simply update its quantity property by 1. Okay. And if the case is no, then we will simply push the item. Okay, and for this if else, we will also do the same, like we will simply push the item. Okay, like fresh entry. So I hope the algorithm is clear to you all. Now let's start coding. Okay, so okay, so what we have done here, we have just used the spread operator. We are saying that the object that we are getting, okay, so you keep your current properties that you have and just add one more property, that is quantity, and the value will be equals 1. Okay, now let's check if state dot cart items dot length is greater than 0, Okay, so if its length is greater than 0, what we need to do is we need to check if it already exists. Okay, and how we can check? Okay, so friends, what we are doing here, we are using sum. Okay, so it will run this condition, okay, over each and every element of this array. And if any of the conditions satisfies this, any of the either one, okay, so it will return us true. Okay, so this means, like, if this item's ID, okay, that we want to update, if its ID matches the item's ID that are currently in this cart items array, so it will return us true. Okay, so once it returns us true, then what we need to do is we will simply get its index and we will simply update its quantity by 1. Okay, so let's see how we can get the index. Okay, so this is how we can get the index. Okay so once we get the index, what we need to do is we simply need to like go to that index. Okay, item index. Okay, we simply need to go to that index and then we need to access the property that is quantity. Okay, and we simply need to update it by 1. Okay, cool. I hope the code till here is clear to you all. Okay, we will simply check if it is already existing. We will find its length and we will find its index and we will simply update its quantity. Okay, if it's not already existing, then we will just simply push it to that array. Okay, one more thing, here, and if the cart item's length is 0, okay, there are no items in our cart, then also we have to do a fresh entry. Okay, so cool, our code for add to cart is done. Okay, now let's perform this mutation from here. Okay, okay, so I hope you all know how to perform the mutation, as I've told you all in my previous videos. Okay, and here goes the mutation name. Okay, so as I've told you, we can perform the mutation like this, but we are not going to perform the mutation like this because this is not a good practice. Okay, so how we are going to perform the mutation? With the help of action. Okay, so this $store.dispatch. Okay, and here goes the name of the action. We have not created our action yet, we will be creating it. Okay, and here goes the payload, and payload is, what is the payload? Payload is the current item that we want to update. So this dot, and we will get it from this dot details. Okay, cool. Now let's go here and let's create the action. Okay, so we get access to context object and we can also have our payload. Okay, it is our arrow function, and then the context has this commit property. Okay, and from here we can commit our mutation, that is add to cart. Okay, add to cart mutation, and we can also send the payload at it. Okay, we can also send the payload. Okay, so cool. Let's try clicking once again. Okay, so cool, as you can see, our cart item count is updating. Okay, let's wait for a second. Okay, so let's try using our, you know, this Vue.js extension. Okay, that I have told you, dev tool. What we need to, let's load the state. Okay, so here we can have a look at cart item count, and also let me minimize this, and also we have our cart items array initially 0. Okay, now let's press add item. Okay, so as you can see, the mutation is performed. the type is add to cart, and the payload that we got is this object. Okay, as you can see, samosa, and we have our cart item count as 1, and we also have one object in our cart item array. Let me maximize it for you. Okay, yeah, I hope this is visible. Okay, so let me add one more entry. What I'm doing. Okay, so cool. As you can see, one more mutation is performed. Okay, and how to refresh the state? Yeah, we have got our cart item count as 2 and 2 entries in here. Okay, so yeah, we will not get 2 entries in here because we will just get our quantity increased by 1. Okay, so earlier it was 1, now it got 2. Okay, so this is the logic of add to cart. Now let's perform the logic for remove item from cart. Remove item. Okay. Here we also need to perform the action. Remove item. Okay, and we have to pass the object. Okay. Okay, so let me minimize this and let's write another mutation, that is remove item. Okay, it also gets access to both of them. Oops. Okay, cool. Okay, so this is our algorithm. Basically, what we need to do, first we need to check if our cart item's length is greater than 0 or not. If yes, okay. But obvious, we only need to run this remove item if there are some cart items in our if there are some items in our cart. Okay, so if there are some items in our cart, we need to check if the payload, if the item that we want to remove from our cart, it is already existing in our cart items or not. If yes, then we will simply find its index in our array, cart item array, and we will just update its quantity by 1. I mean to say, we will just downgrade, we will just minus 1 the quantity. Okay, and we will finally update the list. Okay, so let's code. Get the existence, then we will find the index. Okay, okay, so cool. Now what we need to do, we simply need to state.cartItems, we need to access that index. Okay, and at that index we need to access the property, that is quantity, and we simply need to do minus 1. Okay, cool. We also need to do state.cartItems count minus minus. Okay, we also need to reduce this by 1. Okay, so let's see if this works. Remove item. Okay, so our items are being added to cart. Let's try removing them. Okay, as you can see, our items are getting removed. Okay, so yeah. Okay, so this is a bug. We are getting this in negative. Okay, so yeah, we need to fix this. Okay, so if the quantity is not equals to 0, okay, then only we are going to perform these two operations. Okay, cool. Then only we are going to reduce the cart item count and the quantity by 1. Okay, so now let's see this once again in action. And let's also make use of the tool that we have. Okay, let's quickly add 1, 2. Okay, so 2 mutations are performed, as you can see. Now let's try removing the items. Let's first check the state. Okay, cart item count 2 and we have quantity 2. Okay, now let's try removing it. One. Okay, so as you can see, mutation is performed, remove item. Okay, so we have payload and we have type remove item. Okay, now let's see over here. Yeah, we have cart item count as 1 and we have quantity as 1 over here. Okay, Guys, there is one bug over here. That is, we also need to update the list, okay? That we are not doing right now. This thing over here, okay? So if it is equals to 0, okay, then we need to do this. Let's try once again. Add item. Okay, so our items are added. 2, as you can see. Now let's try removing it completely. Okay, 2 mutations are fired. I hope it is removed. Okay, so as you can see, cart item count 0 and no entry in our cart items array. Okay, so I hope it is visible. No entry in cart items array. Let's do once again. Okay, let's try this with cake. Let's add its 2 quantities and now let's add the Chinese noodles. Okay, so 3 mutations are performed. It means our cart item count should be 3 and there should be 2 objects because one is having quantity 2 and another one is having quantity 1. Okay, so now let's try removing this chili, I mean to say noodles, completely. Okay, let's fire our remove item mutation. Okay, and now let's have a look. We have 2 cart item count and yeah, we only have 1 object in our cart items array. Okay, that is cake. Okay, so if you have liked the video, then do give me a thumbs up and do subscribe to my channel and do show your support to me by sharing my video to others also. So guys, I will catch you up all in the next video. So till then, stay tuned and thank you.